Hello, and welcome to the Harmonagon Project. Our previous video covered the basics of notes and steps. Notes are selected by clicking the numbered buttons around the circle, and steps represent the distance or space between notes. Intervals are two-note chords, so to create an interval, I'll click Make Chord, and then select two notes, say C and F, and click Enter. As you can see, the harmonagon has connected the notes with a straight line and drawn arcs around the circle to help visualize interval structure. Unused notes are also minimized. The web-like structure inside the circle is a dodecagram that connects every note to every other note. The dodecagram represents every possible interval, that is, 12 times 12, or 144 intervals, when counting the unison and octave as one. Understanding intervals is crucial to chord and scale construction, so I will demonstrate all 12 possible intervals where the note C is the root, counting unison and octave as one. The first and smallest interval is the unison. Here the notes C and C form a unison, or a doubling of the same note. The next interval is a minor second. Here the notes C and C sharp, or D flat, form a minor second, or two notes separated by one semitone. The subsequent interval is a major second. The notes C and D form a major second, or two notes separated by one whole tone. The next interval is the minor third. The notes C and E flat or D sharp form a minor third, or two notes separated by one whole step plus one half step. The following interval is a major third. The notes C and E form a major third, or two notes separated by two whole steps. The ensuing interval is a perfect fourth. The notes C and F form a perfect fourth, or two notes separated by two whole steps plus one half step. The next interval is a tritone. The notes C and F sharp, or G flat, form a tritone, or two notes separated by three whole tones, hence the name tritone. A tritone is a special interval, because it represents the midpoint of an octave. Notice how the line divides the circle into equal halves. The following interval is a perfect fifth. The notes C and G form a perfect fifth, or two notes separated by three whole steps plus one half step. The subsequent interval is a minor sixth. The notes C and A flat or G sharp form a minor sixth, or two notes separated by four whole steps. The next interval is a major sixth. The notes C and A form a major sixth, or two notes separated by four whole steps, plus one half step. The following interval is a minor seventh. The notes C and B flat or A sharp form a minor seventh, or two notes separated by five whole steps. The succeeding interval is a major seventh. The notes C and B form a major seventh, or two notes separated by five whole steps plus one half step. And finally, the last and largest interval is the octave. All of these intervals can be found under the Learn menu, under Chords and Intervals. Or you may select all intervals from under Sequences. When intervals are displayed, the note labels change to abbreviated interval names. The small m is used for minor, while the capital M represents major. A capital T is for tritone, capital P represents the perfect intervals, and the letter R signifies the root. The terms root, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh refer to the seven natural notes. So in this case, C is the root or perfect unison, D is the major second, E is the major third, F is a perfect fourth, G is a perfect fifth, A is the major sixth, and B is the major seventh. The minor intervals, whether a minor second or a minor third, minor sixth, or a minor seventh, each contain one fewer semitone than their major counterpart. In other words, minor intervals are like major intervals that have been flattened or lowered by one semitone. I encourage you to use the Learn menu to study and practice playing or singing the various intervals. In our next video, I will cover inversions. Until then, have a great day.